New tonight at 10, a failed discussion in Marshfield that was based around COVID-19 vaccination requirements for certain city employees. News 9's Isaac Dinesen is live in the newsroom with the results of that meeting. Isaac.
Yeah, that's right, Catherine. Marshfield's Finance, Budget, and Personnel Committee heard a proposal to require COVID vaccines for non-represented city employees. Here's a closer look at why it was denied.
We want to at least be prepared.
The city of Marshfield looked to plan ahead, citing potential changes coming down from the federal government concerning vaccine requirements.
We don't know exactly how soon we're going to get a decision from that, but with the state of COVID, I think people are hopeful that there'll be a decision from the Supreme Court soon.
That decision is regarding the federal emergency temporary standard, where large private companies would require employees to submit proof of vaccination. However, it wouldn't have affected a public employer like the city of Marshfield. Multiple committee members didn't feel the timing was right to make this type of change.
And I think that this is such a hot topic that unless we have to implement something because somebody higher up says we have to, I don't even want to touch this.
Under the proposal, employees would submit proof of vaccination voluntarily, with no penalties for those who'd choose not to comply. Protected employees from the police department, fire department, and public library would have been exempt, which created division. But with the proposal falling through,
opposed,
nay.
And the motion fails.
No action was taken.
And it's unclear if a similar proposal will come up again in the future, but we will keep you updated. The next committee meeting is scheduled for later this month. Live in the newsroom, Isaac Dinesen, News 9 WAOW.